Good morning. I have 10 minutes to convince you that the global research into back pain management is asking futile questions. My experience in this area comes from my work with the Back Pain and Functional Movement Training Center, which are integral to my spinal surgery practice. I also have to thank Medivance for sponsoring my attendance at this meeting and clarify that they are in no way conflicted with the content of my talk. When it comes to low back pain, there are many countless misguided articles like this, asking the question and seeking to assess the value of non-surgical and surgical management of low back pain. Randomized controlled trials comparing the two modalities have to date been unhelpful in guiding treatment for the growing global epidemic. As members of the World Spine Societies, we should be guiding the long overdue and imperative paradigm shift required to control this epidemic. It remains non-conjectural that we have a problem. In many publications, including the World Health Organization and The Lancet, low back pain is considered the leading and growing cause of disability worldwide. In light of these poor outcomes, an undercurrent of anti-spinal surgery sentiment is surfacing, and I don't think many spinal surgeons are fully aware of it. The message propagated from parts of the back pain therapeutic industry who are unqualified to discuss lumbar fusion surgery are misinformed and harmful. It is being delivered to the wider public, patients, primary care physicians, health insurers and government. It is ironic that lumbar fusion is the vilified target for reform, even though the total number of spinal surgeons in Australia is approximately 200. Compared to about 45,000 non-surgical professionals managing low back pain on a daily basis with unvalidated methodologies. These are the existing management options for low back pain, so let's interrogate their utility. The default management strategies that people engage in by a massive majority are non-surgical. In fact, according to hospital health registry data, only 745 non-decompression fusion surgeries are performed per year on average. This is in the context of 1.5 million people in Australia meeting the criteria of chronic low back pain per year. If we group the therapy based on the fundamental change or modification to the patient's physiology, we observe that the massive majority of interventions delivered to people with low back pain has a structural rather than functional focus. Could this be a clue as to why we are failing to control low back pain and why these questions are futile? Why is the research underwhelming in providing clinical guidance for the $100 billion back pain therapeutic industry? This is the first and biggest problem that we need to get past. This is the paradigm shift. If we don't abandon the idea that there is no cause for low back pain, then this ideology will be a self-fulfilling prophecy for failure. To then be critical of the industry's use of imaging, invasive procedures, and potent pain medications, out of desperation, of course, is cruel and immoral. This may sound harsh, but it is true. Just because peer-reviewed literature doesn't yet recognise a cause for the epidemic of low back pain doesn't mean there isn't one. Epidemics like low back pain must have a simple root cause, otherwise they would never reach epidemic status. The primary purpose of the musculoskeletal system, which includes the spine, is to permit movement. Therefore, a musculoskeletal system failure is indicative of, and by definition, a movement dysfunction. Movement dysfunction, the functional disease that causes the cascade of downstream symptoms and associations. We cannot simply continue to treat the downstream effects of the condition and ignore the central cause. Our current treatment paradigm for low back pain is massively geared towards addressing structural deficits related to the spine, not the glaringly obvious functional ones. Hence, it is no surprise that we are failing. For success, a tandem approach is required. Control symptoms and eliminate cause. So back to our opening statement, what is the evidence and why is it a futile question? We would never ask which treatment is better for bacterial pneumonia, Panadol or oxygen, even though both are utilized in treating it, because neither address the root cause disease. Analogously, the same can be said for surgical fusion and conventional non-surgical physical rehabilitation. The comparison is futile because neither address the root cause, the functional disease of movement. Looking closely at existing research reveals truly how poorly conventional interventions for low back pain are when we subject them to scientific scrutiny, regardless of their surgical or non-surgical approaches. The reason? Neither address the functional disease of movement dysfunction. Is there a place for surgery or physical rehabilitation? Yes, but not to cure low back pain. They have very clear structure-focused objectives. Lumbar spinal fusion surgery has the one objective of stabilizing the motion segment. Non-surgical structural rehabilitation has the one objective of conditioning the paraspinal soft tissues. The clinical requirement for these interventions must involve, not exclude, the spinal surgeon. When required, surgery is vitally important to give the patient the capacity to reverse movement dysfunction through specific and distinctive functional movement therapy. Once conceptualized as a root cause disease, movement dysfunction will usher in a paradigm shift in managing symptoms of structural breakdown, low back pain, and disability. What does specific and distinctive functional movement therapy look like? It is the relentless pursuit of virtuosity in movement, being extraordinarily good at the ordinary movements of daily life. So in conclusion, the epidemic of low back pain symptoms are the consequence of a simple, ubiquitous root cause functional disease, movement dysfunction. Lumbar fusion is highly effective at achieving its sole structural objective, stability. Structural surgery cannot resolve functional back pain. Conventional structure-focused physical rehabilitation also fails to resolve functional back pain. Lumbar fusion is only required for low back pain symptoms to resolve instability if that instability is preventing engagement in functional movement therapy, which is required to reverse the primary disease, movement dysfunction. Failure to reverse movement dysfunction after fusion surgery will result in the misnomer of failed back pain surgery syndrome, which is in fact failed back pain rehabilitation syndrome. Functional movement therapy in control cohorts, biased to poor outcomes, shows on average a 50% reduction in ODI scores after 8 weeks. So thank you for listening, and I hope that I have effectively described to you the necessary paradigm shift required to address movement dysfunction, which is the root cause disease for the global epidemic of low back pain. Thank you very much.